ويوم يحشرهم وما يعبدون من دون الله فيقول أأنتم أضللتم عبادي هؤلاء أم هم ضلوا السبيل قالوا سبحانك ما كان ينبغي لنا أن نتخذ من دونك من أولياء ولكن متعتهم وآباءهم حتى نسوا الذكر وكانوا قوما بورا.
And on the day, which is the day of judgment, when he will assemble them, i.e. those who worship idols, and that which they worship instead of Allah, of idols, and will say, Allah will say to the idols, and it is said, he will say to the angels, was it ye who misled these my slaves, from my obedience and commanded them to worship you, or did they, themselves, wander from the way, and worshipped you out of their own whims?
فقد كذبوكم بما تقولون فما تستطيعون صرفا ولا نصرا ومن يظلم منكم نذقه عذابا كبيرا وما أرسلنا قبلك من المرسلين إلا إنهم ليأكلون الطعام ويمشون في الأسواق وجعلنا بعضكم لبعض فتنة أتصبرون وكان ربك بصيرا وقال الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا لولا أنزل علينا الملائكة أو نرى ربنا لقد استكبروا في أنفسهم وعتوا عتوا كبيرا يوم يرون الملائكة لا بشرى يومئذ للمجرمين ويقولون حجرا محجورا وقدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل فجعلناه هباء منثورا أصحاب الجنة يومئذ خير مستقرا وأحسن مقيلا ويوم تشقق السماء بالغمام ونزل الملائكة تنزيلا.
We never sent before you, O Muhammad, any messengers but lo, they ate food, as you do. This is in response to the disbelievers of Mecca who said, what ails this messenger, of Allah, that he eats food, and walked in the markets, just as you walk. And we have appointed some of you a test, a trial, for others, we test the pure Arab with the client, and the noble by birth with the lowly and the rich with the poor. Allah said to Abu Jahl and his host, will ye be steadfast, with the companions of the Prophet, Salman and his fellow believers, such that you become with them, in relation to religion and other matters, equal and that you sit together with them. And thy Lord is ever seer, that they will not be steadfast regarding this. It is also said that this means, will you be steadfast, O companions of the Prophet, in 401 the face of their harm until I grant you the reward of the steadfast, and your Lord sees who believes among you and who does not.
الملك يومئذ الحق للرحمن وكان يوما على الكافرين عسيرا ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتى ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا وقال الرسول يا رب إن قومي اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا من المجرمين وكفى بربك هاديا ونصيرا وقال الذين كفروا لولا نزل عليه القرآن جملة واحدة كذلك لنثبت به فؤادك ورتلناه ترتيلا ولا يأتونك بمثل إلا جئناك بالحق وأحسن تفسيرا.
And those who look not for a meeting with us, those who do not believe in resurrection after death, i.e. Abu Jahl and his host, say, why are angels not sent down unto us, to inform us that Allah sent you to us, and, why, do we not see our Lord, to ask him about you? Assuredly they think too highly of themselves, to simply believe, it is also said that this means, they think too highly of themselves when they ask to see Allah, and are scornful with great pride, refusing to believe, it is also said that they dared to ask for a tremendous thing when they asked for the angels to come to them. On the day, which is the day of judgment, when they behold the angels, at the moment of death, on that day there will be no good tidings, the angels will say to them, there is no good tidings, i.e. there is no paradise, for the guilty, for the idolaters, and they will cry, i.e. the angels will cry, a forbidding ban, the glad tiding of paradise is forbidden for the disbelievers, and it is also said that this means, the disbelievers will say upon seeing the angels, let a great distance be between you and us.